Okay. Mic check, mic check. That should be good. Oh, right away. Didn't wait 1 second. What's up, Sook? Sorry. Well, I couldn't find anyone to play any games.
I honestly didn't know that that would happen.
So instead, I'm gonna play some old Super Nintendo games, but that were enhanced. I'll explain. So it's called, as it says in the title, MSU1. It's like a hack that they put on the Super Nintendo games that opens it up, where the games are no longer restricted to what they originally were, like the size that they were. They're opened up, to, I think, to like 4 gigs. They can be 4 gigs in size. Originally, Super Nintendo games, like 32 megabits only. Oh, okay, cool. No problem, bro. Appreciate you coming in for a minute, though. Anyway, so like this hack opens it up where games could take up over the size of a CD. It's like having a Sega CD, but on Super Nintendo. And it gives you an idea of what could have been if the Super Nintendo CD actually came about. If you don't know, Super Nintendo CD was about to be a thing until Nintendo skipped out on it. They had the prototype and a working prototype. It was gonna be the Super Nintendo PlayStation. But then Sony decided to do their, or Nintendo skipped out on the project, and PlayStation, Sony decided to do it on their own. That's that history. So this is a kind of like a what if. There's a bunch of games that utilizes. Look at this, it's cool, the artwork. This is the Contra artwork. This is from the arcade game? Yeah. Yeah, they had the Nintendo disk drive. And yeah, there was a couple of prototypes that made it to the US, but they were only prototypes. Look at this mock-up Contra, Stallone, Schwarzenegger. So I'm playing this off my Super Nintendo. This is playing off of actual hardware. Off of my flash cart. Oh yeah, they go for a lot of money. They're super, super rare. I don't know what the difference in any of these is. If there is a difference. Ooh, arcade OST. Ooh, that's cool. So I can use the arcade's music. This is the movie. Contra movie? What? Skunk, what's up? MSU1 enhanced. Yes. Yes, yes. What is this? 3 different ones. Thank you. So once again, this is being played off my Super Nintendo, off of actual hardware. But it's running off of a chip. So it's running off of a flash cart, it's called. Oh, this is the Japanese version? Oh, it's the Japanese version of Contra. This is the one that had like the cutscenes. That's too bad it's not in English. So it's weird, when Contra came onto US, it was, the cartridge size was cut smaller for whatever reason. And we had all these cutscenes and some background animations taken off in the US version. Very weird. And this cool little like ghouls and ghosts like map. So this looks all the same. Let me see something real quick. Oh wait, can I reset it from here? No, I gotta restart the whole thing. Oh, wait. Might be able to do it. Oh yeah, okay, I can do it from here. What is this different? There's different OSTs here. VGS. What's VGS? Ooh. Like an enhanced sound? Whoa! Very nice. Sounds cool. Oh shit! Almost died. I like the remix music. It sounds cool. Very, very cool. I like that. Oh, that's badass. So I wonder what the last one is. It must be like orchestrated. Oh, so I should also clarify also that the person who made this, put this together, obviously he was using a Nintendo, This is a Nintendo game. Ported to the Super Nintendo. Oh, what? Yeah. Orchestrated. Ah! Game over. That's cool. Alright, let's see what the other songs sound like. There's third one. I wonder what this is. They all seem to have the same intro. Guitar version. So is this like a live band? Ooh, you can hear the guitar in that. That's cool. Doesn't sound that different from the other one. Ah! Okay. Now, we do also have two other styles you can go into. Let's see. Because that's original game right here. So apparently there's the arcade game. Let's see what this... Does it have a different intro? Or is it just the music by itself? Oh, nice. Oh, wow. That sounds very cool. Yeah, that's badass. Oh. That's slightly different notes. Kind of like it. Not gonna lie. Ooh. So I wonder what the movie one, because the last choice you get is a movie poster, and it even says in the top, Schwarzenegger and Stallone. That's the arcade one, because that's the arcade flyer. That's interesting with the alien in the back. Art Unknown Movie OST. I wonder how this one's gonna turn out. Okay, that's different. This has an actual intro. What? That's a Predator intro? Yeah, it's Predator. That's interesting. Nah. It's a bit dark. Oh, such a great soundtrack.
Good. It's been a long time, General.
What? How much of this movie are we getting? Oh.
We've got a transponder fix on their position. About here.
No way.
So why don't you use the regular army?
Because some damn fool accused you of being the best.
Oh, they're going to do the handshake?
You son of a bitch.
In a Super Nintendo. Enough.
Make it easy on yourself.
Okay.
You never did know when to quit, huh?
Now, what do we gotta do?
Simple setup. One day operation. We pick up their trail at the...
What do you mean we? General.
I'm afraid we all have our orders, Major.
Interesting. Yeah, there you go. Epic handshake. No. They are not. Yes, they are. Here comes Stallone. Oh man, they're weaving this into the Contra movie, or the Contra universe. That's fantastic. And it's funny because, like, Contra's already been kind of like,
that's all,
interwoven with both of them, in that their covers have used the same poses and images as movies from Stallone and Schwarzenegger.
You interested? You can't possibly want to stay here for another 5 years.
In here, at least I know where I stand.
Yeah, just hear me out first. The covert operation's being geared up in the Far East.
Why me?
Nobody knows that terrain better than you do. The risk factor is very high. You'd be temporarily reinstated in the forces, and if the mission's successful, there may be a presidential pardon.
We're gonna go through all this, and then we're gonna be met with like 8-bit graphics.
Yeah. Good. I'll get the necessary clearance. All clear? I want you to know that I did what I could to keep you out of here. I know. It's up to you.
It's all for you. That's great. That's the guy that actually ported everything. Infidelity. Schwarzenegger's Bill Reiser? No. Stallone is Lance Bean? Somebody made that. That's fantastic. So I wonder if there's gonna be cutscenes in between. Oh wow, the music! That's crazy! What? Damn. Hold on. I'm trying to do that 30 life code. No? Doesn't work in this? Like, I want to hear the rest of the soundtrack. Damn. There we go. It like changes the whole feel of the game. Just a different soundtrack. Oh, I can carry two weapons! I just realized that. Like the Super Nintendo game. That's brand new too. That's really interesting. Damn it. Changed my weapon. Didn't want to do that. There we go. That's much better than I did before. Dang it! There we go. That's so weird. I'm gonna try to go through the whole thing. I don't know if I can. Probably with 30 lives I could, but not three. This is a Rambo song, 100%. Got our spreader there. And extra life. Oof. No. There we go. Ah, stop jumping off the edges. There we go. Here goes my pixels. Yeah, my spot right here. Can't get hit, I hit him. I thought I was going to be pinned down on that. There we go. Beautiful. Oh, I can just duck right here. Yeah. Easy peasy. Don't need that. Got it. I probably yep, little rolling pins. Another life. Nice. I gotta jump for this one. Beautiful. Last one, and we get to the boss. Jesus. There we go. Just Gina, what's up? How you feeling? Doing playing this a port, it's called. From a Nintendo game, obviously. This is Contra. You might know from regular Nintendo. Somebody ported it to be a Super Nintendo game and put enhancements on it. So what they did is they put it like a movie enhancement. Even had a whole intro. It combined the intros of Rambo and Predator as is these two guys. The two characters we're using are Schwarzenegger and Sylvester Stallone. Really, really cool. It has a whole intro. What's cool is that, again, this is called an MSU1 enhanced game. It's like if a Super Nintendo had a CD attachment to it, or if it went through with the CD attachment. So I am playing this on a Super Nintendo. This is on actual hardware. But it has to be through a chip, like not a chip. What's it called? A flash cart. So what they did here, it's really interesting, is they took the soundtrack of the movies, both Rambo and Predator, and they used that as your game soundtrack. It's really interesting. Oh gosh, okay. I thought it was gonna follow me. Pretty familiar with this game. As you could probably see, I'm pretty familiar with it. Anyway, what's up with you? What you gaming on tonight? I was going to do something multiplayer, but nobody came up, and I thought about it real late. So that's why I was like, you know what, let me try this this game. This release came out, what, a day or so ago? Like the guy, it's one guy who programmed the whole thing. He takes Nintendo games and ports them over to Super Nintendo. It's a kind of like a practice programming, just like a challenge. But what he's doing now, because people like it so much, he's adding more stuff to it. So like I said, like where he combined the worlds of Predator and Rambo. Just because he can. There we go. It sounds so cool. So weird. So what's cool, like, is that in the game, like, we're playing the movie, quote-unquote, version of it. You could also play with the arcade soundtrack. Pretty neat. And you could play with the original Nintendo soundtrack if you want to. And two other variants of the Nintendo soundtrack, which is like, one that's kind of like an orchestrated enhanced version of it, and the other one being a fully instrumental, like a guitar instrumental version of it. Oh, this is 100% Predator song. Matter of fact, I remember this is when they were fighting the Predator. I remember this song very vividly. Dang it! I can never make it over that jump properly. Oh, we got an extra life. That's good. Dang! I saw it at the very end, too. I'll take that. That's invincibility. That'd be very handy right here. Kill everyone off. Oh shit, I gotta fight this guy normal. Dang it! Almost had to jump. Oh, come on! Oh my goodness. Oh, okay. What's also cool is that instead of using the USA version of Contra, they're using the Japanese version, which had extra memory and extra graphics and effects that weren't on the US version. This map being part of the old one, the little cutscenes there at the end. There's some background elements that are moving on this version that are not on the other one. Son of a bitch. Extra amazing Contra finesse. Yeah. What's up, Super Lemon? How you feeling, bro? Hope everything's going good with you. Playing an old school Contra. We're doing the Super Nintendo, though. This is a port handled by someone on the hacking scene called Infidelity, where he takes Nintendo games and ports them over to Super Nintendo. Mainly just because he can. But a lot of times he'll add enhancements to them. This one he added like a whole intro. Part of the fucking Predator intro and the Rambo intro. With credits saying that the two characters we're using are played by Schwarzenegger and Stallone. It's really cool. Like a full motion video intro. Damn it! I can't believe I did fell for that. Let me just get to the last stage. Oh, an extra life, yes. There we go. I haven't used a continue yet. And this is with the base three lives that you get. That's it. Although I think they set it up where you get extra lives faster. Because I noticed I'm getting a lot of extra lives. Oh, the music. This is 100%. This is Aliens. This is from the Alien soundtrack. There is no denying that. Am I finished this? Did I do it in one shot? I'd be pretty impressed myself. Ooh, another life! Yeah, they definitely increase the amount of lives you get. Or like lower the amount of points needed to get an extra life. Because it wasn't this easy before. But I'm happy about that. I probably needed that. That might have been the spreader shot. Oh, Jesus. Ooh. Easy, buddy, easy. Okay. Also on the Nintendo one in the U.S. Oh no! Dang it. In the U.S. that background doesn't move like that. That's only in the Japanese version. Oh shit. This is gonna be really hard with a basic gun. Dang it! One more life. I can do this, I can do this, I can do this, I can do this. Extra life. Let me get that top first pod, and I'll be fine. And this game is over. There it is. GG's. Get to the chopper. That's awesome. The Predator ending. That's amazing. Sometimes I finished the game now. Dang, and it was only on one credit. And of course it just resets. It's cool how it lets you choose what soundtrack, like what version you want to play, of course. So this is the original right here. The 2A03 is the original Nintendo soundtrack. So original, like you're playing off of Nintendo. Same thing. VGS. I'm not sure what this stands for, but it sounded like an enhanced audio, like an enhanced audio version of it. So the same soundtrack, just, you know, a better version of the instruments, like the MIDI instruments. MET is like, that sounds like a live orchestra, like a live band playing, which is cool. Then you have this, which is cool because this is the original flyer for Contra for the arcade. And this is the arcade game, OST, which is really cool. That's another cool addition. And then, of course, what we just played, complete with the Xenomorph in the back. And in the top it says Stallone and Schwarzenegger. And it shows the first couple of minutes of the intro of each movie. Probably Predator longer, because Predator is the one they go with in terms of what plot they go with. So it starts with Predator. They go through all that, and then they get Stallone out from... I forgot what Rocky is at. I mean, what Rambo. Where he's in the prison. He starts off in the prison. And he gets bailed from there. Probably part two. But very, very cool. We'll move on. That is badass. Now, the one he worked on right before this... these are all Super Nintendo ports he's done. Contra, we just checked out. He's done DuckTales, Mega Man 2, 4. We've played the Metroid one before. We also have Mike Tyson's Punch-Out. I think this is just a straight... conversion, though. Like, no bells and whistles. Oh, wait. It doesn't have the thing on the top. The scoreboard and your health bar. Oh, it's in the bottom now. I wonder why. Not sure if I like that better or not. It's cool how it scrolls in and out like that. Do you? The problem is that there's a lot of emptiness going on up top. Like, I love how it scrolls to the side. That's cool. It adds more, like, pizzazz, I guess, whatever, to the image. But the problem is you got all that up top that's doing nothing. You gotta put something up there. Maybe.
Hmm.
Yeah, I mean, having the life bars at the bottom makes sense also because you're directing most of your vision at the bottom anyway. So it's kind of like right there, easy to see. But yeah, like I said, the only problem is you end up with that emptiness up top. Alright, that's it. That's this guy, he's done. Von Kaiser. This is cool, like if you all you gotta do is dodge a punch, couple hits, he's dizzy, uppercut knocks him out. That's all you gotta do. Dodge a punch, couple hits, uppercut, auto knockdown. That's it. 1, 2, 3. Oh, you were there watching? I watched a little bit of him when he was practicing. I need to do that too. I've never finished this game. I've never beaten Tyson. Or, Mr. Dream. If you will. Oops. Oops. Alright, here we go. Fucked it up. I fucked it up, you know, every way. Get in here, skunk, if you want to. You could be my motivation for Punch Out. Fucking A. Oh, come on. Oh, 259. Holy shit. At the very last possible second. That's hilarious. No problem, bro. So it's really cool, like I said, the guy ported over to Super Nintendo. These Nintendo games, you can automatically see that the colors pop, like they're much more vivid. There's no more the flickering in a lot of the games, or slowdown. That's all been ironed out because Super Nintendo's a stronger system. The only problem with my particular system is I have a multi-chip system. It's one of the original systems. So the video output isn't quite as good or as sharp as some of the newer systems. The problem is the newer versions of the Super Nintendo don't have the best quality cable output. So the best quality cable output for our old system is called SCART. It's an RGB cable. Basically like component. It's the same thing as component. The old Super Nintendo's use that. They can use that. Which, like mine, has it open. But I don't have the clearest picture from that output. However, the newer systems, which have a clearer output, don't use that SCART cable. It sucks. The only way to really kind of find a middle ground is to get your system modded. I haven't gotten around to doing it. This guy's easy. Flamenco, the first time you fight him, you bait him into an uppercut, dodge, and just go left to right punch. Left, left, right, left, right. He's not gonna ever block it or stop getting hit. Gets up, uppercut, and that's it. He's not getting back up. Hippo. I remember being stuck in his asshole. Clarity, well, the input speed are the same. It's the best clarity can only be gotten from those SCART cables, because that's the best output you can get. The problem is that the Super Nintendo itself, the old ones don't have their chips that they use for their video output is flawed in a way to kind of smear the graphics. Kind of like the N64, they kind of did a smear to make the graphics look a little smoother. And on a CRT, you wouldn't notice the difference. There'd be no difference. But when you start upscaling, this is where you start seeing the flaws. So if you were to take one of my Super Nintendo and like a newer model, like the Super NES 2, like the next gen one, if you take a Super Nintendo 1 and a Super Nintendo 2 and put them on a CRT, they would look pretty much identical, right, through regular AV cables. But if you were to use my Super Nintendo through AV cables, regular AV cables, and the Super Nintendo 2 with the AV cables, the Super Nintendo 2 would have the clearer picture. In terms of upscaling, you would see a clearer picture of the Super Nintendo 2, because it has a better output. However, like I said, it only goes up to regular AV cables, whereas the Super Nintendo original ones go up to RGB, which is the highest it'll go. Don't know why Nintendo just decided to stop supporting it for whatever reason. There's a way also to kind of mitigate the smearing, as it were, which I'm using right now. There's one of the options on the RetroTINK that kind of sharpens up the image, you know, as best it can. But it's still not as good as having like an actual proper, they call it a one chip system. Or getting mine modded to look like a one chip. That's it. Oh shit, I'm at the title bot already? I wasn't even thinking about it. Alright, this is where the game kinda like, the difficulty spikes. At least for me it does. Oh! Ooh, that was looking bad. Oh my god, oh my god. I swear it feels like I'm actually getting hit. Man. Oh. You know what's a really good version of it? I thought was the one on the Wii. It's an awesome game. I thought they did a really good job of enhancing the game, making it look better, you know, with the 3D characters and like updated graphics, but still keeping the charm and the feel. Yeah, it's really good too. One of the few games where I would say like the newer version of it, I think, is well worth the play. Better than the original? Nah, I wouldn't say that, but like, definitely good in its own right. Ooh. He's already trying to get tricky. I'd have been fine if I just kept those two stars. I got greedy. Hello, Tokyo. Yes! Caught him. Oh shit! Knocked out. Very nice. This guy drives me nuts. He has a glitch or I don't know if it's a glitch or what. If you hold down, it'll stop his uppercut from happening. Let's see if it still does it. And you can use it to get, like, a star. Yeah, it still does it. Oh! Does he get knocked down automatically? With uppercuts? No! Hmm. Hijo de la madre! Oh, his laugh. I hate it so much I made it a sound bite. Fuck. Why is he waiting? Why is he waiting? Oh, thank you. Can I just keep doing that? I'm gonna make you feel punch drunk. Oh, I don't have him anymore. He makes me anxious by waiting. He makes me anxious by waiting. It messes me up. I always have issues with him because of that shit. Bastard. Busted. We'll move on to a different game. Alright, let's see. Let's check an actual enhanced game. Okay. Let's see if this is the one I was thinking of. The Super Mario World is supposed to add a bunch of extra stuff that wasn't in the original. Oops. We're just gonna go through this. Play this game forever. So there's no real MSU-1 enhancements, at least not yet. It looks the same. Oh, I should have gotten the yellow things to make this much easier. Too much. So the description I read says that the base game is pretty much the same, except that they added different music for different parts of the levels. Or different stages, like overworld map. So we'll try to get to the overworld map too, and we'll see if that's true or not. The speedrun. Oh, another great song. There is a version of this, and you said on the other one. Actually, we'll run that one also. As soon as we get to level 2 here. Cool little trick. If you stay on the gate, oh wow, I fucked it up already. But if you manage to stay on the gate, you can use all these guys and start getting one-ups. Actually, I probably still could have. Let me see. See if he comes down from the bottom. No. He does. Should be pretty soon I'll start getting one-ups. There he goes. So now, from this point on, every time I kill one of these guys, let's get one-ups. Good way to boost. Some early one-ups, early game. Dale! With the resubscribe, thank you, bro. What's good with you, bro? Hopefully everything is good with you. More than welcome to jump in the chat if you want to. We're playing some MSU1 games, so these are the enhanced games. I've explained it to you before, I think, where it's like as if the Super Nintendo CD actually did happen. That's what MSU1 is. Wow. So this is an MSU1 game in that it's largely the same, but they said like there's different graphics for Luigi. So it's a different character sprite for Luigi on you know, other than just the color difference. And what else? And the overworld theme is different depending on what section of the overworld you're in. So I'm about to go into Overworld 2 and see if there is a difference. If this is the right one. No, this is the same one. No, it's the same one. Yeah, this is the same thing. I wonder what it is different then. We do also have... Oh man, you should see that Contra! I'll show you. You got a second? You got a second? Please tell me you got a second. Check this out. This one was just ported a couple of days ago. It was released to the public. Yeah. So this is obviously Contra. So this is the original poster for Contra on Nintendo. The Japanese version. You can play this either with the Nintendo OST, the original Nintendo OST, an enhanced version of that, like the instruments, or like an fully real instruments. That's not what we want. You can play it. This is the arcade flyer of Contra with the arcade soundtrack. Very cool. Also not what we want. Or you could play it So here's what they insinuate. He really was absolute ace of an actor.
Let's go.
So that's what they're insinuating, that they picked up the general story of Predator, because they're in the rainforest and all that, to kill these aliens. And then they're picking up Rambo to be the secondary person.
Sorry they sent you to such a hellhole.
I've seen worse.
Yeah, you have, haven't you? I told you that I'd help you when I could. You interested? You can't possibly want to stay here for another 5 years.
In here, at least I know where I stand.
Yeah, just hear me out first. The covert operation's being geared up in the Far East.
Why me?
Nobody knows that terrain better than you do. The risk factor's very high. You'd be temporarily reinstated in the forces, and if the mission's successful, there may be a presidential pardon. You interested?
Yeah.
Good. I'll get the necessary clearance. All clear?
Yes.
I want you to know that I did what I could to keep you out of here.
I know.
It's up to you.
That's the guy, that's the actual guy who ported everything over. Schwarzenegger's Bill Reiser. Stallone as Lance Bean. And then you got the game. Which is the Rambo theme? No. I'm not sure which movie intro they're using. But just to show you real quick, they're using the Japanese version of the game as all the extra cutscenes. But look. The music. I already went through the whole game. But it's really cool. Like, the music they use is very appropriate. Isn't that badass? Yeah, there you go. Makes you want to fight for democracy. I love it. The music is great.
Hey,
All right, let's see what else we can get into. So, MSU1 games. So here goes another pretty cool example of MSU1 where they kind of use it to make a soundtrack, right? It's just a soundtrack. So gonna get DMCA.
Knowing the day I was born, the nurses all gathered round, and they gazed.
let the carnage begin!
Dang. See, the messed up thing is that this game did came out on Genesis. They could have very easily done this on the Sega CD. I think this could have actually been a thing. Let me see, is there any more songs? I think that's all the songs. Yeah, that's already all. Switch up to a different one. That's a really cool idea of like what you can do with MSU1, that style of gameplay. Let's see, these are the ports. They also have Zelda 2. DuckTales also with like an orchestra soundtrack. Mega Man 2 and 4 with also a soundtrack. Castlevania, Mario All-Stars. Demon's Crest with the sound with the orchestral soundtrack, although really it already had it pretty much. Super Metroid with an orchestral soundtrack. Mortal Kombat 2, I think they used that to do the arcade music instead. Killer Instinct, where they use the killer cuts, like the actual arcade music instead. Fuck yeah. When it was loud and in the arcade and you could hear from across, like wherever the entrance is, the arcade unit could be like in the other side of the arcade, but it was loud enough where you could hear it. There's a version of this, you know, the Super Nintendo one here that has, they even reintroduced all the full motion videos of all the characters. All the full motion video from the arcade into it. But it doesn't work on an actual Super Nintendo. It's only through emulation. My blue orchid. There she is.
Orchid.
Orchid.
Orchid. fight on.
It's also very bright. How did it go? Am I doing it right? With a mode 7. Love that character's like music. It's probably the best music. I forgot the endings. What can I use? What am I? Oh, what was one of the endings that I could use a finisher? That's one. That one's the other one. I can't get the movement to work. There it goes. Yeah, and then I can finish it off with the fireball. What is Super Nintendo controls? Weird. I messed it up. I was too far away. You remember nothing of it? I remember some of the stuff. This song. Every time I hear it, I remember your mix that you made. Your 10-minute mix. Before it was a thing. You already doing 10-minute mixes. There was another move, she had a combo out of it. It's true, Skunk. If we would get off of our asses. Okay, let me see. No! I thought it was backpack 4-4 soft punch. Oh, it's up here, idiot. I'm pushing the wrong button. That's why. One more chance. He's got a good song too. No, we're playing till we get to what's his name? Fulgore. Oh no! Bastard. Or do I have it wrong? Maybe I'm thinking of TJ Combo's finisher. No, I'm pretty sure that's what it is. I'm gonna try it one more time. Not then that's it. Oh, his music. I guess I can't remember it. I thought I could. But you get the idea. You get the idea. What else do we have here? We did Legend of Zelda. That's the original game. With the orchestral soundtrack, which is pretty cool. Street Fighter 2 Turbo just has the arcade soundtrack. I don't remember what All-Stars did. Link to the Past, you've seen that. That's where it has the intro and the orchestra soundtrack. Mortal Kombat 3, I think it has also the arcade music. I don't know what else to go with. Hacks. Oh, they got the Star Fox fast ROM. What they did is they took Star Fox and they kind of they redid the how to say it? They unlocked the CPU to make it faster. So there's more frames of animation. It moves smoother, which is really cool. And then the same thing with Super Ghouls and Ghosts. It takes away a lot of the slowdown. Still has slowdown, but it takes a lot of it out. You got Sailor Moon fighting game. Castlevania Uncensored, so like all the purple blood or whatever, now it's actual red blood. some of the gorier bits they put back in that were taken out from the U.S. Surprisingly, they took a lot out. We'll do this fast ROM, Star Fox EX. Well, we got two of them. Oh, this is Star Fox 2. But maybe it doesn't work. Alright. I don't know what happened there. That was just kind of creepy. There it was. So yeah, this is all the enhanced CPU power. Go out to level 1. Let's go to level 2. Put the one in here that has this, but with the that enhanced soundtrack. Remember, I remember Dell. You used to have that CD that had this song, some of the songs on here, but they were like enhanced. Okay. Whoa. Get some of my shield back. Getting whooped on. Oh, it's all gone horrible.
No.
And we got full shields even. Had no chance. Oh, barrel roll. I like how he positions himself right in front of you. Surprisingly, with the low frame rate, it's still very easy to control. Alright. Now we got some firepower. Ooh, shield. Probably gonna need that. Oh shit. Oh shit. Come on. Ooh. Andros, I failed you. Yay, got a new fox. Alright. Well, that's with, like, 10% or whatever, 20% speed increase, which really isn't much, but an idea of what they can do with it is pretty cool. What else do we got here? To play... I don't even know why I put this on here. Because I really don't want to play Zelda 2 ever again. Never again. We'll do, Hack Games. Hyper Street Car. Oh, they just do Street Fighter characters in Mario Kart. It's pretty funny. Super Ghouls and Ghouls Restoration. 1 second. Let me see what all that does. Oh, okay. I guess they got rid of some of the crosses on the super on the American version, so it's been restored. And the Japanese names of the bosses has been restored also, and removes most of the slowdown. Kind of cool. And this is regular Prince of Persia. I don't even think it's the Super Nintendo one. This is regular Prince of Persia. Mega Man 2. Ooh, what's this? Oh, so you get to use MSU1 Mega Man or Super NES Mega Man? So it's just regular Mega Man 2 on Super Nintendo. Oh! Nice. The PlayStation startup. Oh, so this was on the PlayStation version of it? So this is an official soundtrack. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Yep. We'll take this all day. Where do I start? Nice. Big heel, big heel, big heel. There we go. Didn't even get me anywhere. That music sounds fantastic. Now the game's pretty much, I got the best weapon in the game already. Metal Blade I can direct anywhere I want to. So we'll just Woodman. Oh, the music's so good. We'll be right back. Yeah, I don't have to worry about anything coming from me in any direction. Oh, nice. Look at that. Full health. Easy peasy. It. And Metal Blade hurts most bosses. We'll go with Heat Man, why not? Never mind, I forgot about this one. This one might be tough. Who was that? Ronan, what's up? So what we're doing is, Ronan, we're playing MSU1 games. MSU1 was just like a hacked term that they're using for basically Sega CD on Super Nintendo. Oops. So what they do is, they use it to enhance games, mostly by adding CD quality sound. But they can even do stuff like intros. I'm going to show you a better example here in a second. Oh, shit. Here goes the fun part. This is a hard part. You know what? We're not going to worry about it. So for this game, what they did, and they said in the beginning, they did Mega Man 1, but with the soundtrack. I guess they did a port of this on PlayStation, on the PS1, and so this is the PS1's remastered version of these songs. Pretty cool. So what it inspired me to play today? There was this MSU1. That's right there. What it's MSU-1. That's the name of the. The hack, I guess, the unlock, because it modifies the Super Nintendo games from being their limit of 32 megabits to, I think, like 4 gigs or something like that. So basically, like, if you could put it on a CD or a DVD. All it does is enhance the, or it opens up the amount of space, the size of the games, not, you know, the graphics themselves. It's still the same thing. So what's cool is that this guy, his name is Infidelity, he ports old school games, like Nintendo games, to Super Nintendo, and sometimes he'll add more stuff to it, right? More, a little extra to it. Have you ever played Metroid on Nintendo, Ronan? Let me know if you've played regular Nintendo Metroid, the old school one. Okay, so you should be familiar with it, right? This is the one that really made me take to see how this guy does this. So what you could do is he ported over Nintendo Metroid, the original Nintendo game, Metroid, to Super Nintendo with enhancements. You could play the game with an orchestral soundtrack. You could play it the original way. You could play it with these. This is the disc system. This was the old, not floppy, drive that the Famicom used to use. They ditched it. It was only in Japan. And they ended up making it a regular cartridge. But this is what it sounded like. Or you can use Metroid Zero Mission, the Game Boy Advance game, as your soundtrack, which is really cool. All very, very cool. However, if you pick the most enhanced version, this one, you get this. By the way, I'm playing this on my Super Nintendo. I'm using a flash cart that's holding all the information on there. I'm not sure why it's glitching like that. Infidelity is the name of that guy. Does it sound awesome? It sounds so awesome, the music. So what you do is you can go to it. I actually went through and finished the game. You can hear the music right there. So the rest of it is the regular Nintendo game. You just got enhanced music. Isn't that kind of cool? Also, what's cool though, he added this from the Super Nintendo game. So now you have a... every time you get an upgrade, even when you upgrade your suit, the color will change. And with that, you get an actual map, which was not in the original. The original sorely needed the map. So he has a fully set up map, just like Super Metroid. So watch, we'll go over here. Was it the jump? Oh no, that's the ball mode. See, now you got the morph ball. It pretty much makes this the definitive way to play the game. I finished this game not too long ago, and I did it through this version of it. It plays, I would say, exactly the same, but I'm not 100% familiar with the original game. Like, I've played it before, but not like Contra or something where I would know exactly how the controls are. But I have played his port of, well, Contra, and his port of Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, and they're both exactly the same. So that's cool, right? So this is the one that came out just a couple days ago. Where it is. This is, oh man. You went all out for this one. Del, have a good night, bro. Appreciate you hanging out. I'll probably be finishing up here soon, also. So he ported the original Contra. So this is OG Contra. Nintendo, they actually he ported the Japanese version, which had more animations and cutscenes, which you'll see in a second. So you can play the original game, and it gives you three OSTs. So this is like the first one is straight Nintendo, regular Nintendo OST. VGS is like an enhanced Nintendo version, so enhanced instrumentation. But still MIDI, but enhanced instrumentation. And MET, I don't know what they stand for. But MET is like actual instruments. So like if a live band was playing it. Cool, very cool. You also get the choice of the arcade version. OST. So the arcade version had a different sound processor that was closer to the Genesis. But it's cool that you could play Nintendo Contra with the arcade soundtrack, which is cool. However, just like with Metroid, decided to go all out with this Contra thing. Now you have Contra in this whole, you see the Xenomorph in the back, which makes sense because they fight Xenomorphs. Contra logo, and it has Sylvester Stallone and Arnold Schwarzenegger. There's a reason for this poster, and this is the reason. This has to be his best intro so far. I don't know how he's gonna top this. See if you can recognize the references. Got the alien one, very good. Thank you.
good. It's been a long time, General.
Come on inside.
We've got a transponder fix on their position. About here.
So why don't you use the regular army?
Because some damn fool accused you of being the best.
You son of a bitch.
They had to add that, right? The epic handshake. Again, man, this is off my Super Nintendo. This, again, this is what it would have looked like if they had the Super Nintendo CD, which eventually, of course, became the PlayStation.
Now, what do we got to do?
Simple setup. One day operation. We pick up their trail at the...
What do you mean, we? General...
I'm afraid we all have our orders, Major.
Sorry they sent you to such a hellhole.
I've seen worse.
Yeah, you have, haven't you? I told you that I'd help you when I could. You interested?
Isn't it, though? Isn't it, though? It's ridiculous. But it makes sense. Because remember, the box arts always depicted them as basically Arnold and, Arnold and Stallone.
A covert operation's being geared up in the Far East.
What up, Buck?
Why me?
Nobody knows that terrain better than you do.
God damn it, what's up?
The risk factor.
God damn it, what's up?
You'd be tempted. Because I'm trying to talk again. And if the mission's successful, with goddamn mutant. Presidential pardon.
How you feeling, bro?
You interested?
I'm okay. Oh, Rambo.
So I was just showing that. I'm playing Contra.
I'll get
you
this
are?
This is the intro to Contra.
What?
In this universe, this version of it, Contra's the two characters, Bill Reiser and Lance Bean, are played by Schwarzenegger and Stallone. You just missed the part with the intro to Predator.
What the fuck?
This is a Super Nintendo. I'm playing this on my Super Nintendo.
That's great.
So it replaces the soundtrack with the soundtrack of the movies from Predator, from Rambo, and from Alien.
That's great.
So watch when I go to the first part. It uses the Japanese version of the game. Again, it has the extra cutscenes. Unfortunately, they're in Japanese still instead of English.
Oh.
But listen to that.
That's fucking great.
It like it changes the entire feel of it, right?
Yes.
I did a full run on this earlier.
Oh.
I already went through it, yeah. There it goes. Remember
the game loses.
Yeah. You remember. This is one of the greatest lines ever. And I lost. I'm not as good as the first neck coin that.
No. Oh my god. He just ran through the fucking game with the splatter.
I don't even think he lost, man. Right?
That's one of the most ridiculous things I've ever seen.
Isn't that awesome?
Oh.
The music and everything. Yeah, so you can play the game with this soundtrack. You can play it with, obviously, the original. You can play with the arcade version soundtrack, which I think was a cooler addition. Enhanced versions of the original, and even like a live band version of it.
That is so fucking great. I love it.
Oh, and they added the this wasn't in the original. You can, from the Super Nintendo game, where you can carry two weapons. So you see on the top, I can carry my regular weapon.
Yeah.
That was added to this. Dude, the best is the final stage, because it's like, it's aliens. 100% aliens. Like, the music, it's awesome. Yeah. Oh. So this is, like I said, this is what the MSU1, this is what they do with it, where they can kind of change the game.
Yeah.
It unlocks the Super Nintendo game's limit from 32 megabit. That's what it was initially. That's all they were able to go. Now they can go up to 4 gigs. Almost the size of a DVD. Oops, shit. All right. This is not nowhere near. My first run was way better than this. I'm doing awful right now. I did, I don't know if you guys remember Rock and Roll Racing.
No.
It was a racing game done by Blizzard, matter of fact. On Super Nintendo and computer, where they use MIDI versions, but the music was inspired by, you know, classic rock tunes. Ozzy Osbourne, Steppenwolf, stuff like that. So, okay. In the original game, you play, like MIDI versions of these tracks, right? You know, they're obviously what they are. But with MSU1, we'll see. Where is it? Yeah.
Knowing the day I was born, the nurses all gathered round, and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone.
So if you never played, this is like a perspective racing game. Where you do a bunch of different races to build up your car, get to the next level, build up your car further. But again, the whole gimmick was the MIDI versions of these songs. When the MSU1, they were just like, fuck it, let's put the actual songs in there. How cool is that? Well, you get the idea. We did more of the game earlier, but that's some of the things we can do. I don't know if I showed you guys the Zelda one. Let me see. This was also another really, really cool one that kind of opened up people's eyes to, like, oh wow, you can, this is the kind of shit you can do. So a fully orchestrated soundtrack, pretty standard. Right, so it's pretty cool so far. You're already like, all right, that's pretty neat. But then they give you this. Like, this is an original animation.
All right, Uncle. My first harvest. Well, these apples are perfect. Just the right color and shine.
Let me see. This is a great start for the season.
This has got to be the best apple orchard in all of Hyrule. Everyone's gonna travel here to try my apples.
Your apples, huh?
I've even got a name for the orchard.
Oh, yeah? And what is that?
Well, it would make sense to name it Link's Legendary Apple Orchard. What's so funny?
Okay, I have to check somebody in real quick. What is this?
So, like I was saying, this is a Link to the Past. But they added an original animation. Like, this is originally made.
Okay.
This was one of the first, I guess, examples of MSU1 where people were like, oh shit, we can do this with this technology. With Super Nintendo games? Let's eat. Besides, just add orchestral music or whatever.
Thank you.
Link before he was Lunk.
Protected me after my parents died. And have been taking care of me ever since. You're like a father to me.
It's just an intro. I think it's only an intro. I don't think the rest of the game has any other animations.
You're growing up, Link.
Still, it's badass.
You're growing up.
Music. It kind of sets up the intro to the game itself.
Okay.
Even gives you the first clue of where you're supposed to go. And then the regular game starts. So these will all work on, obviously, on emulation. But they're also made on with the ability to play on natural hardware. Which is really, really cool. You can hear the music and the sound effects right away. Big difference. Right. Now we're ready to go. I just gotta get to that list of the castle. Because it's my favorite track in all of gaming. Here we go. Sounds so awesome. Even the original, like, just from the Super Nintendo. It's one of my favorite tracks. It, like, sets up the entire mood. Sucker. 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 It sounds like dangerous. It sounds very dangerous.
Yeah.
Like you're in a place that you shouldn't be in. And it's a really good orchestrated version of it too. Sounds big. It should. It's orchestrated. Bones, what's up, bro? We're probably gonna be finishing up here pretty soon anyway, but I wanted to show you this is an example of that MSU1. I don't know what you would call it. The hack, I guess. Even Zelda's lullaby sounds cool. So it just takes Super Nintendo games and unlocks the space that they're given. And increases it from like the 32 megabits that they're initially at to about 4 gigs, which is gigantic. Most games just use it to put like orchestral soundtracks or live, you know, live versions of the music. But sometimes they can even do like it showed you in this one, where they add intros, they add extra stuff like in Metroid, where they add a quality of life improvements. Thank you. Oh shit, I lost myself. Where am I going? I'm on the wrong way. That's where I'm supposed to go. That was weird. Anyway, you get the idea. Cool. Pretty cool, isn't it?
Yes.
I did also show a more basic thing, Killer Instinct, where they replaced the Super Nintendo soundtrack with the arcade soundtrack, which is, again, it just makes it so much cooler.
Yeah.
They could even do stuff where they hack the system, they hack the games themselves, and like for the instance, for like Star Fox, it'll increase the frame rate. Super Ghouls and Ghosts, it takes away a lot of the slowdown. They actually increase the clock speed of the CPU. Again, this is all works on normal hardware. Jurassic,
that's actually great.
Yeah, Jurassic Park, they added a save feature that wasn't in the original game. That way you can actually, you know, save your progress instead of having to do all in one big shot.
Yeah.
I was just playing Punch Out also. I didn't see a difference except that the life bar and menus is at the bottom instead. It was weird. DuckTales just has a soundtrack, like an updated soundtrack, which is cool. Mega Man also has different versions of the game's audio. I don't know if it had an intro. I don't think it had an intro. So you could use a powered up from the PSP. The original game. And this is like the, you know, somebody playing, like a band actually playing the music. I don't know if, does this have an intro? I think this one had an intro. Let me see. Look at this Capcom vs. SNK intro.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, Bones, like I said, this is off my Super Nintendo. And they had that song.
I love it. That was from the show, wasn't it?
Oh, this is from Mega Man.
I thought that was on the Mega Man show too, that version of the song.
Oh, probably. It could have been. I didn't watch much of the show.
Oh.
Yeah, so you get the original game with those cutscenes. I don't know if there's anything else involved with it. Alright. Oh. Oh. Anyway, we'll be done right here. We'll probably be done after this. I just, when I saw that that Contra that he released today, I was like, oh, I gotta play it, I'll stream it. And when I saw that intro, I was like, yeah, dude, I'm sold. I'm probably gonna subscribe to that dude's Patreon. Because that's too awesome. Like, for that much effort?
Yeah.
You know? He deserves money for that. I'll put the information at the bottom of the YouTube video when I upload this to YouTube.
Okay.
Ha, sucker!
You got it.
I got so lucky. Boom!
Oh, that was so cool.
Cupman, I forgot who Cupman even hurts. Anyway, we'll call it right there, guys. Just wanted to check out that Contra more than anything else. Have a good night, everyone. We'll go check out one of my guys, All Out Gaming. He's playing some Tekken 8 right now. So... you guys have a good night. Thank you again. Buck, appreciate you hanging out, man. Have a good night, okay?
Peace. You too.